One of the first things you learn in life is that things aren't always the way they appear to be. Domestic bliss, for example. When Danny was little, he believed that his parents' love was forever, that their home was the center of the universe, and that the only way the Walker family would ever leave Chicago was if they were moving to Disneyland. One of the next things you learn in life is that everything you believed as a little kid is subject to revision. Which is how Danny ended up in the tiny hamlet of Walker Falls, Minnesota, which, from what he'd seen of the place, other than its potential to bore you to death, seemed like a perfectly normal place to live. So maybe it wasn't so normal after all. In fact, as Danny was soon to find out, Walker Falls, Minnesota was about as far from normal as you can get without a transporter room. The day the trouble began started like any other in Danny's new hometown. A nice, cheerful commute with his peers, followed by an enthusiastic welcome from the principal as he walked in the front door. Even the custodian seemed glad to see him.
Oops.
Danny didn't know what unwritten law he'd broken by moving here, but he was beginning to suspect it might be a hanging offense, and his personal hangman would no doubt be Ryan Kankle, Dark Lord of the Stupid.
Nice tackle, son.
Thanks, Dad.
Danny didn't really lose consciousness. He just did what he'd learned to do early in life. He played dead. Live to fight another day was his motto.
Walker chocolates.
Of course, as his dad was fond of pointing out, this would only work until that other day finally came.
It's him.
And you actually had to fight. Then again, his dad has spent the last 5 years fighting his way into bankruptcy and divorce. So what did he know?
James Walker.
Good morning.
Ah, good morning, Herr Schmidt.
The Deutschmark is killing the dollar this morning.
Really? Well, good for the Deutschmark. Does this mean you're coming?
Actually, we're not so sure.
You're not sure.
Walker chocolates, hold please.
I see.
I hope I haven't destroyed your life.
Oh, well, no. That's actually a bit of a relief, Herr Schmidt. Well, you see, our local hotel, Shea Cheese, is very small. And what with the French coming over to look us over as well.
What French?
What's that, Miss Vanderspool? The French on line two.
You know you can't trust the French.
Appetit moment. C'est vous plaît.
You'll let me know by the end of the day. That'll be wunderbar, Herr Schmidt. Wunderbar.
Busy day at the factory, apparently. How are we feeling now, huh?
I think the other apes are starting to accept me as one of their own.
Starting over is always rough, Danny. I know.
Well, as I always say, it's not whether you win or lose, but where you land when you bail out.
Bailing out. I guess that's something the walkers would know all about, huh?
I haven't lived here since I was a kid. I don't know where all the bodies are buried.
Now, there were pros and cons to walking home from school in late October. The pros included a great autumn air smell, wood smoke, burning leaves, and just a hint of carbonized marshmallows, plus lower temperatures, which meant that you could wear that jacket that makes you feel sort of cool and hides the fact that you're built like a scarecrow in case you spotted that girl that just knocked you out. Halloween decorations, jack-o'-lanterns, glow-in-the-dark paper skeletons, and bedsheet ghosts hanging from the trees. At least there were where Danny grew up. And if he'd been paying attention, he might have noticed that these traditional signs of Halloween were nowhere to be found in the town that bore his family name. But Danny was too busy worrying about the cons of walking home from school in late October.
Boo!
Boo? Dork. Hey, Ryan. Dork. So, what's up?
Your number, that's what.
Come on, Ryan. I mean, I already gave you my snack-packed tapioca pudding, my Roswell glow-in-the-dark alien pen. Plus, we had that nice game of kill the quarterback in P.E. Remember? What have I done to get you so mad at me?
I'm not mad at you, Danny. I'm concerned about you. You see, Walker, you're different. And in the big city, that may be a good thing. But here in Walker Falls, being different can get you hurt or worse. Know what that is, Danny?
A sepulcher?
Wrong.
A crypt?
No, dork. It's a place where they bury somebody. Or should I say, what's left of some body. And his name was Curtis Danko. You see, Walker, Curtis Danko was different too. He couldn't play sports, he couldn't fight, and he never wanted to do what all the other kids wanted to do. Like in art class. When all the other kids would paint pictures of normal stuff like barns and tractors and baskets of apples, Curtis Danko would paint pictures of monsters or aliens or scenes of a world gone mad. Then one day, the city council announced that they were putting this statue in the town square for the big centennial celebration. They asked all the eighth graders at Walker Falls Middle School to do a sculpture of their hero. And the one with the most votes get turned into that statue for the town square. While all the other kids worked during the school day and kept their sculptures out in the open where people could see them, Curtis Danko would keep his covered up and sneak back and work on it in the middle of the night, all alone, with nothing but moonlight and fireflies to light his way. To this day, no one knows for sure if what happened was a horrible accident or the end result of some sinister scheme. All anyone knows for sure is that the last time Curtis Danko was seen alive was Halloween night, 1981. When my dad got to the art room the next day, he noticed something. Something wrong. And when he opened the door and looked inside, all that was left was Curtis Danko's burned-up skeleton, his completed sculpture, and a message written in his own ashes. If you ever have another Halloween, I will return and destroy you all. Since that day, 20 years ago, Walker Falls has never had another Halloween.
That's crazy. You actually believe he's gonna come back and destroy us all just because your parents are handing out Kit Kat bars?
Yeah, we do. And you wanna know why? Because my father was blind for 3 days after he looked at Curtis Danko's creation. He said that that sculpture he covered up in the kiln room was so horrible that only someone who'd actually met the devil face to face could have sculpted it. When he told people what it looked like under that shroud, nobody dared even look themselves when they took it away. They just carted it off and buried it in there with him. And now you're gonna go in to take a look.
Why exactly?
Because I wanna know what it really looks like. But just in case the sight of it makes a person burst into flame or turn to stone or makes your head explode, I want someone to try it out ahead of me.
What about him?
What kind of description could I get from him? He can hardly talk. With you, I'll get the masterpiece theater version, if you survive. Ah.
Yeah, you know.
Get him!
Now, Danny wasn't much of an athlete, but over the years, he got pretty good at evading conflict. And as it turned out, there were actually some advantages to being built like a scarecrow.
Hey, Ryan, what's the... Never mind.
And the narrator to you, the audience. Though who I am now, who I was then, are two very different things indeed.
Oops. Today, on this old house, how to finally get rid of that awful wallpaper your wife bought back in the 70s.
Uncle Fred, as the whole town and most of the tourists in the upper Midwest used to call the me I was then, wasn't really Danny's uncle. He was his grandfather. But as long as anyone can remember, I'd insisted that everyone, even my own family members, call me Uncle Fred in public to keep the human symbol of the Walker Chocolate Company front and center at all times. Which was fine with Danny because there was no way he could ever call a guy who could play Nintendo, skateboard, and drive a go-kart like me, Grandpa.
Who was that mutant chasing you?
He's one of my many fans. So where's Dad? He promised he'd start making our Halloween costumes tonight.
He said something about working late on his big spooktacular.
Sure. He's already got his costume.
Yeah? What is it?
The Invisible Man.
So, did you pound him?
Got a Viking living with him.
Don't lie to me, you cowardly weasel. The Vikings are in Dallas this week.
No, I mean...
Never mind. Look what I got.
What are you gonna do with that?
We're gonna get rich with it.
How?
How much would you pay to see what's under the shroud?
Nothing.
And how much would you pay to not see what's under it?
Red Bear deserves a chance because it is a classic. It will look great in the Guinness Book of World Records. But the dog Viper is far more aerodynamic and therefore more likely to actually achieve the goal. What do you think?
I think it's amazing you know the name of a toy car made in the 60s.
The Germans are coming. The Germans are coming.
Okay. No need to panic. You go get my old army helmet from the attic. I'll call the VFW and see if we can borrow their tank.
I worked hard to make this happen, Dad. Real hard.
Don't we know it?
Just trying to follow your example. Gotta make your mark in this world, remember? Uncle Fred?
Well, there's more than one way to make a mark, Jamie. Being a big success is no guarantee of being a good father.
At least we agree on that.
Dad!
Running late, Danny. Whatever it is, it'll have to wait.
But there's this kid. You've got to hear what he said about Halloween.
Someone's bothering at school, Danny. Just talk to your teacher.
But this kid's dead.
Violence never solves anything, Danny.
But
trust me, son. Things are going to get better. After tonight, the name Walker's going to mean something in Walker Falls again.
Little did James know, he was absolutely right for all the wrong reasons.
Mrs. Kinkle!
Mrs. Tyranny!
See you inside.
All right, folks. I know what you're thinking. Town meeting, bad news, right? Well, guess what? We have a special guest tonight who's come up with what he tells me is a surefire solution to our economic woes.
What, he's lowering prices at Journey?
He hasn't told me he's paying yet, mind you.
Taylor.
But seeing as how he can afford
hello, James.
I didn't know you were still in town. I heard that you, married well?
Yes, I did. The Ann Arbor Stensons. Very upper crust, you know.
Oh, yeah.
All the right schools, all the right functions, and dysfunctions. I didn't divorce quite so well, however, so I came back home. I'm the school nurse now.
Before I bring him out,
I'm sorry.
No, don't be. I like my new life.
No, I'm sorry, Aunt, that I'm in perfect health. See, because you're the...
They're all yours.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. So, hello again, Walker Falls.
Yes.
I say hello again because although most of you probably don't recognize me now, believe it or not, I actually grew up in this town.
Yes, some of you may remember me as little Jamie Walker. We used to TP some of your houses on Halloween. On Halloween. Holiday. Yes, well, as some of you may also remember, Walker Chocolates was once the fifth most successful producer of chocolate in the United States of America.
Yeah, till your old man shut it down.
Well, that's because Curtis Danko said that if we ever had another house...
If it wasn't for that greedy old man sticking his nose in everything, this Curtis Danko thing wouldn't have happened in the first place.
You can't have it both ways, folks. If you want to believe in the legend of Curtis Danko, then my old man had no choice but to shut the factory down in order to save the town from certain doom. Don't you remember what it was like when the factory was running night and day and folks would head down to Jonathan's pumpkin patch, carve jack-o'-lanterns, us kids would start to get our costumes together, our entire lives devoted to one night of fog and pranks and first kisses, and of course the biggest prize of all, a big fat bag of candy. Well, we can have all of that back. All we need is to start up that old factory again. It's all still up there, folks. The machinery is oiled and ready. The ingredients are in the hoppers. Miss Vanderspool and I even ran a test batch of the old recipe to make sure that it was as good as we remembered. All I need now are the people to make it all work.
So, what's the catch?
The catch is that I've spent everything I've got just to get to this point. Now, in order to pay all of you, I need to bring in some investors who can see what I see when I look up at that old factory up there. Which is why I've decided to invite some very wealthy German investors here to Walker Falls on October 31st.
Excusez-moi, but was there any particular reason you chose that particular day?
I chose October 31st because it's Halloween!
He said Halloween!
Oh, don't say it again! Jeez, Hank!
Because it's time for trick-or-treat! Because I've got a whole warehouse full of costumes and masks and pumpkins and candles and glow-in-the-dark paper skeletons just sitting up there in the factory. And with your help, setting up booths and exhibits, putting up a few Halloween decorations and such. I'll be bringing those Germans right here to Walker Falls for the very first Halloween Night Spooktacular! Stuff.
Scary, huh?
Oh, goodness.
I believe I warned you about this.
I'll tell you what I believe. I believe that I saw hope in the eyes of a lot of people in that crowd tonight, and excitement in the eyes of their kids. I believe that if this town woke up, found all of our Halloween spooktacular stuff put up, despite their fears, they would get caught up in it.
You're a dreamer, Danny.
Well, so were you once upon a time. I don't understand what happened to you. Uncle Fred, I knew, was ready to take on the world. He was a civic leader. Built this house with his bare hands. Built that factory on the hill. Built this town and a fortune.
He also built the kiln room that Curtis Danko died in.
It was an accident, Dad. You gotta stop beating yourself up. For 20 years, you've turned your back on everything you ever loved. You walked away from the town, from the business. You weren't even there for Mom, and she needed you most.
What are you doing?
When your dad was your age, he always wanted to go see an Apollo moon rocket go off at Cape Kennedy. And I'd always say something like, hey, that's a great idea, sport. As soon as I get done going over these inventory reports, we'll start planning that trip. I saw in the paper today the space shuttle is going up next week. I figure the space food sticks and the tang your dad put in the car back in the 60s is still good. If I drive day and night, I'll get there in time to get a good seat down on the beach. Want to come along?
I can't. I got school.
I'll write you a note.
They won't take it. You're not my dad.
Yeah. I guess that's true. I'll be back sooner or later. We do our own landscaping.
What is the matter with you people? We told you we didn't want anything to do with your hollow. Your hollow, you know what? And what do? You go ahead in the middle of the night and set it up anyway.
You're a lying, cheating, bad person.
Hey, everybody! Wait till you see what he put up in the town square!
It's a warning!
It's a pile of pumpkins.
Big, beautiful, possible pile of pumpkins.
Mommy, can we buy a pumpkin?
Well, I don't know.
No, honey. Remember Curtis Danko.
Oh, what the heck? I mean, he didn't say if you ever buy another pumpkin. I haven't had pumpkin pie in 20 years.
Bill, what's pumpkin pie?
Commit the ashes of our dear brother, Uncle Fred Orkut.
I always thought death was supposed to be the end. But for me, it was just the beginning.
There is a time for all seasons.
For 3 days, as the folks of Walker Falls wrung their hands and shed a few polite tears.
Hey, it's getting dark. Let's get on with it.
A time to stop.
I lay trapped between the earth and what lies beyond. Held in place by what felt like some cold, invisible hand. I didn't realize it at the time, but I had unfinished business in the world of the living. And there were forces gathering that were determined to make sure I met my destiny.
Sorry, Danny. I know you miss Uncle Fred. I miss him too.
Why? Why do you miss him? What about him do you miss? His crazy costumes? His toys scattered all over the house? Or do you miss him acting out stories for you? Or helping you with your homework? or playing slot cars with you, or building models, or sharing his space food sticks with you, or did you even really know who he was?
Space food sticks?
He stuffed his car trunk full of them, hoping he'd take you to Cape Kennedy. Remember?
I remember when my grandparents died. At first, it doesn't seem real. Then when it finally hits you that they're really dead, you start thinking about all that gross stuff that's happening to their bodies down there.
If you don't mind, I'm still at the it doesn't seem real part. But thanks for the cheery thought.
But it is cheery, when you think about it. I mean, the dying part is sad, and probably scary, just because you can't do anything about it. But what comes next? It's like a miracle in reverse. The cells breaking down, the flesh disintegrating. Everything dissolving away, returning to the earth from which it all came. So all that's left is the memory of the space you once filled in someone's heart.
Aren't you a cheerleader?
What are you doing, Ed?
Just making sure.
What is this place?
You know who Curtis Danko is, right?
The most toasted sculptor in Walker Falls?
Don't make jokes.
Why not?
He might hear you.
Excuse me? This is Curtis Danko's house? Okay, see ya.
Don't you want to see what's inside?
It's getting dark and,
witness the miracles of modern technology.
What is this?
A haunted house. Best haunted house ever.
So where'd you get all this stuff?
People's attics, basements, storage sheds. Even car trunks and tree forts, wherever people have been hiding it all these years.
How'd you get it here with all these paranoid people around?
I didn't. Came to me. hidden in lunchboxes and book bags and sleeping bags at slumber parties. All summer long, kids have been sneaking out after dark to help me build this, and saving up all the candy their parents give them so we can trick or treat in here.
So aren't you guys afraid of the curse of Curtis Danko?
Yes and no. It all happened before we were born. And with Curtis Danko all locked up and Halloween all put away and forgotten, they all feel pretty safe. But they don't want to feel safe. They actually want to feel just a little bit scared, even if it's just for one night.
Why?
Because if you don't get to survive being scared as a kid, how are you ever going to survive being scared as an adult?
And there's so much more to be scared of.
The kids of Walker Falls want their Halloween back. And tomorrow night, I'm gonna give it to them.
Maybe. Maybe not.
What are you doing here?
What am I doing here? No, the question is, what are you doing here? On private property, trespassing. You see, I've been watching you, Dana. Ever since Kelly Starenowitz told me you were poking around in here. People tell you things when you're popular.
Or when you're a bully.
Bully? Me? You've got me all wrong, Dana. Just ask Danny. I'm not a bully. Am I, Danny?
Well, I mean,
he's not gonna do anything. And he can't make us do anything either.
Oh, really? Let's do the math. My mom is cheerleading coach, and my dad is coach and assistant principal at the school. That means he gets to decide who gets hired and who gets fired. He's also going to be the mayor in a few days, and that means he gets to decide who gets a permit to operate a candy factory and who doesn't.
All right, Ryan, we give.
What?
Nobody ever died in war by keeping their head down.
Nobody ever won a war that way either.
What do you want?
I want the room at the top of the stairs.
No way! That's where we're gonna put the dancing.
Trust me, Dana. I've got something much more fun to put up there.
That was close.
Yeah. Close to the most cowardly thing I ever saw. After what happened to your uncle, I would have thought you of all people would want to fight for Halloween.
Hey! Dana?
Kill myself when I looked in the mirror. I mean, come on, a tie?
But I saw you at the funeral, homie. You weren't moving at all.
Oh.
You weren't even breathing.
Sure, look that way. I mean, you tried breathing in one of these monkey suits. I must have gotten just enough oxygen through my skin
to keep me alive. That happens, you know. Your skin actually breathes.
Okay, that makes sense, but what happened? I mean,
I don't know. All I know is I got beaned by a pumpkin. The lights went out, and the next thing I know, I wake up in a box 6 feet under.
What did you do?
I pretty much screamed my lungs out. And there was this sound, and suddenly, like, there's a scratching noise from the outside of the coffin. And then, bang, something breaks through the wood, and there's voices and hands pulling me out.
Ooh. Who was it?
I don't know. It was still dark. I couldn't see their faces. And to be honest with you, I was in too much of a hurry to get the heck out of there to stop and chat.
Does Dad know about this?
Oh, yeah. I called him on his cell phone. Hi, this is your not-so-dead father calling from the grave. No, he doesn't know yet.
Oh, man.
I think I can milk this almost dead thing for at least a month's sympathy, don't you?
At least.
It is good to be back.
It's good to have you back.
And if you look over here to your right, here's where the whole mess started.
Uncle Fred, where are you going?
Out for a little hot air.
Wait, don't you think you'd be better off lying down?
Lying down? Are you kidding? I've been lying down for the last 20 years. I just got a new lease on life. Not gonna waste it this time.
Wait, what if it isn't so much a lease as it is a rental? I mean, what if you're not as well as you think you are? Don't you think people might freak if they see somebody walking down the street whose funeral they just went to yesterday?
Good point.
Danko! Get those mouth-breathing Neanderthal kids out of my body before I eat their non-existent brains! Something wrong with your jaw muscles? Oops!
They're usually in such good shape.
You're dead.
You're right. Or at least I was. And I was resting pretty darn comfy, too. Until I sensed you were up to something.
Sensed?
Now, world beyond this world, Cackle. Times beyond this time.
As you'll soon find out.
Get away from me!
Not a chance, pal. I didn't dig my way out of the ground just to let you get away with this. I came to get you and take you back to the grave with me. Let's go!
Anybody else want a piece of me?
Ah, it's not so bad. Look, it's not even bleeding.
Uncle Fred, you just lost your hand.
Well, good thing my car's an automatic.
Uncle Fred, listen to me. Your hand is traveling west on Mulberry Street at 60 miles an hour.
Well, then, I'll just have to go pick it up.
Maybe you could call Mrs. Kankel and ask her to put it on ice for me till I can get over there and get my hand on it. Okay. See you later.
Thank you.
It's fake.
Yeah.
Gotta be.
Yeah.
Okay, so let me get this straight. Fred Walker now walks the earth as a zombie or a ghoul or something?
No, Sandy, for Pete's sake, don't you get it? It's a hoax!
Walker must have known the town would never go for his Halloween spooktacular, so he allowed us to think we shut him down. Then all of a sudden, weird things start happening. Halloween decorations appear in the middle of the night. Then he and Dad fake the old man's death so he can rise from the grave and start freaking people out! That way, he figures when the guys with the Deutschmarks get here, the whole place will be going crazy and it'll seem absolutely real. Which the Germans find hysterical, so they end up being even more entertained than they would have been, and they end up giving Walker all the money he'll need to save the town.
Well, what's so bad about that?
What's so bad about that is that Curtis Danko really is gonna come and kill us all if we don't stop Walker's greedy little plan!
Well, Dad, you're my hero.
Thanks, son. Takes one to recognize one, you know. Matter of fact, we come from a long line of underappreciated heroes.
Dana!
What do you want?
Listen, I'm really starting to stick up for you before, but I have something really weird to tell you, and I think you're the only person who just might believe me, not think I'm crazy, even though I might be, but I don't think I am. Can I tell you now?
Yes.
You know my dead Uncle Fred?
Yes.
He's not so dead anymore.
I can't believe you'd use your dead Uncle Fred to try and get back into my good graces.
I'm not, I mean...
Mom, how did you find this place?
Oh, it wasn't hard. I just followed the fuse that leads from here all the way to the $600 bomb we got in the mail today from the electric company.
I can explain.
No, Dana, you can't explain. No one can explain the behavior of a teenager. I know, I tried once.
But
I had to go through this Cankle for Mayor nightmare thing. As for your punishment for this inexplicable teenage behavior, you can either pay for this bill out of your allowance for the next 370 years, or you can go to the Cankles with me.
I'll pay.
We'll go. I mean, there's been a lot of inexplicable behavior going on today.
I don't even want to know. You two just go get in the car. I'm going to call your dad.
You don't have to do that. I mean... You know how busy he gets.
Just go.
Halloween, it's so meanie mean.
Don't answer that. With my luck, it's the Germans calling to cancel.
You preached Walker chocolates. Please leave a message.
James, it's Taylor.
I just wanted you to know that Danny is with my daughter and me.
And we're going to this Cankle for Mayor silent auction fundraiser in Oktoberfest.
So,
if you feel like saving us, that's where we'll be.
Taylor.
Hi.
Listen, I can't. I've got the Germans in the air. I've got this whole factory to decorate by myself. Then I got the 4-hour trip to the airport.
I'll go. So, send a cab.
Yeah, you find me one with leather seats and a cell phone, we can talk.
I'll go.
You need to spend some
time with Danny.
And I will, as soon as Halloween is over.
There are garbage trucks and volunteers walking up and down every street in Walker Falls, yanking down
your spectacular decorations.
I haven't even gotten to downtown. Taylor, I appreciate what you're trying to do. Really, I do. But Danny, you know, he comes from a long line of kids that have had to learn how to get by without Dad being around.
Where have I heard that before?
So there I was, parked outside the Cankle estate, trying to figure out how to get in. And suddenly, a miracle occurred.
Excuse me, Mr. Cheesy.
What?
How much are they paying you to do this party?
This finely crafted weeping kitty cat painting might sell for thousands of dollars in stores. What will you generous folks bid for it?
How the heck are you supposed to bid anything? We're unemployed.
Hey! This is a silent auction.
Where is that stupid clown? Ah!
You the clown? Yeah.
You're late.
Oh, I'm sorry, I just been buried.
Let's go.
Wait until Walker sees what we've got in store for him tonight. He's gonna pee his pants.
Am I gonna pee my pants too?
Where'd you get the key anyway?
My dad put his own lock on the crypt to make sure it was good and secure.
Your eye out for his hand. If we find his hand, he won't be far behind.
Hey, Danny.
Dad, what are you doing here?
I'm taking the night off.
But why? I mean, who's putting decorations up at the factory? I mean, who's making the chocolate?
Who's meeting the Germans?
I figured since Halloween isn't gonna happen, we might as well make the best of what we've got. If our chocolate doesn't speak for itself, no amount of Halloween spooktaculariousness is gonna make investors jump aboard. Besides, when's the last time that you and I had a night out together?
Look, who cares? What kind of crazy talk is that? I mean, come on, hurry, go. I mean, you've got work to do. Here, I'll go with you. I'll go. Who wants to put up Halloween deco?
It's gonna be fun. It'll be fun, really. We'll get some drinks.
Teaser clown. Be funny, or else.
Sit down. Have fun. Shall we?
Hi, kids.
Hi, Cheesy.
Who wants to see some magic? Put her there, pal. Go ahead, kid. Shake.
That's my boy. I was always afraid of clowns, too.
Oh, take that!
What's wrong?
That's my identical Fred.
That's Cheesy the Clown.
That's my identical Fred dressed up like Cheesy the Clown.
Doesn't look very dead to me.
That's my point!
My magic hat has disappeared! And I need it back. Here, I'm going to hand you this $100 bill. Whoever finds a magic hand gets the dough.
Magic hand is somewhere in the house.
Trust me.
I really want to thank you, because you have turned one of the worst days of my life into one of the nicer evenings. Oh, look.
Wow, what is that?
It's a rose.
Oh, that's right. I remember. It's just been so long since I've received a rose.
Well, there are more where that came
from. Oh, that's what you said when you gave me my last one, back when we had all the time in the world.
We still do.
This wasn't here when I got here.
Oh, me neither. Why am I really hoping that our kids have something to do with this?
Because any other explanation would be really creepy.
Let's go find the kids.
The kids?
Yeah.
How are we gonna put him back together?
I don't know. Glue.
Great, your uncle the model kid.
Uncle Fred?
Yeah?
You know how you said somebody busted you out of your coffin?
Uh-huh.
I stopped by the cemetery on my way home from school, and there wasn't any hole in your grave, which means whoever busted you out had to do it from under the ground.
Who the heck could be under the
spectacular stuff just yet.
more to go.
How come my boots are on the wrong feet?
Oops. It's for you. Time to take the devil to his new home.
Something to hand deliver to make you feel important.
Uncle Fred?
Yeah.
That's the key to Curtis Danko's crypt.
What did you do? What did you do?
Hun? Do you think these'll help?
Got a little problem.
What kind of little problem, Ed?
Just, you know, somebody broke into Curtis Danko's crypt.
Sounds like some kids messing around.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, except there are some items missing from the premises.
Such as
Curtis Danko's art project.
Curtis isn't gonna like that, Ed. He's not gonna like that at all.
I figured that one out for myself. Mainly on the account of the fact that the other missing item is Curtis.
Someone took his body.
Not exactly. There's only one set of footprints, and they're leading away from the crypt.
He's out there somewhere, Ed. Looking for that horrible sculpture of his. The one that nearly burned the eyes out of my head when I looked at it. We have to find that sculpture, Ed. We can't let him burn the eyes out in the entire town now, can we, Ed?
We?
Yes, we. Ed, we both know how Curtis Danko really got into that kiln. Now, don't we, Ed? I think you better find that sculpture before Curtis Danko finds you.
Interesting option package.
That's better.
No, that is not better. Why is this happening to me? One minute you're alive, and the next minute you're dead, and the next minute you're alive again, but you're still dead. And then all of a sudden there's arms and legs and screw guns and zombies.
Danny, it's okay. We're safe. There are no zombies here.
You're a zombie!
I mean, besides me.
How did this happen?
Danny, listen to me. You remember all those millions of fireflies we tried to catch this summer? And how one day, when it started to turn cold, they just didn't come back? What do you think happened to them?
They died, I guess.
Remember how that weird kid from down the block used to smash him and rub the glow stuff all over his face like war paint? And it still glowed even after the fireflies were all mushed up. Why do you think that happens?
Just a chemical reaction in the air.
No, Danny. It's magic. And when all those millions of fireflies die, their bodies come undone and release their magic into the ground. And it just collects down there, waiting for someone to use it. But to do that,
you need to wish harder than you ever wished for anything. To still be here. With the people you love.
Or the people you hate. If Uncle Fred can wish himself back, why couldn't Curtis Danko? And if he got loose and nothing could kill him either, just imagine what he might do.
Especially if he had help.
Take a vote right now!
Yeah. The election's not till November!
By then it will be too late!
Calm down! The situation is completely under control!
I know there are some strange things going on here, but there has to be a logical explanation. There's nothing to be afraid of.
Well, someone or something put up all those Halloween decorations, and if it's the living dead, I'm gonna have to vote for being afraid.
It's the living dead!
And it looks like I'd win!
Put all the decorations back up.
You know, that's a very interesting story.
Oh, yeah, interesting.
Is something wrong, Danny?
Dad, what if people who really loved Halloween, like, Uncle Fred, for example, what if they had Halloween, issues that they weren't quite over when they died? Did you ever think they might, you know, stay and work through their issues by, rising from the grave?
Not really, no.
Oh. Hi, son.
Well, they didn't take that as well as I'd hoped.
Run for your lives! They're everywhere! They're putting up Halloween decorations!
Who?
The zombie! Does it anyone knock anymore?
What do they want?
Statue!
They want the statue.
Statue? What statue?
Where are we gonna find the statue?
I know where the statue is.
If Curtis wants it so badly that he's gonna raise the dead, maybe if we get it first, we can use it as bait.
Bait? For what?
To lure him back to the grave.
Exactly. Once Curtis is in his crypt, we slam the door and lock it with that chain, and he can sit in there screaming and stomping all he likes. But he'll be trapped long enough.
Long enough for what?
Remember how when that weird kid down the block smushed all those fireflies and rubbed the glowing stuff all over himself? How it would eventually fade and die?
Okay. We have to get out of here. We have to run.
Run? I can't even walk. You guys, get Curtis Danko's statue and return it. I'll take care of your mom and dad. What are you waiting for? Go! Hurry! Zombies! Boom!
Hello, friends. I take these two. I eat their brains.
Huh? Nice try, Uncle Fred. But we have other plans for them. And you.
Ladies, use your guns!
You know what? Kill them! Besides, I know some of those zombies!
What are they worth?
Probably human flesh! We
puts his hands on her.
What did he do to us with a statue?
It nearly burned the eyes out of my head just glancing at it. Maybe if anyone looks at it any longer, they turn into stone or burst into flame, turn into a pillar of salt or something. Is that what you want? What are you doing?
I just want to leave something for my family so they know what my last moments were like.
They're not gonna take me alive.
Zombies at the corner of 5th and Euclid. Waste anything but time.
All units, all units. The citizens of Walker Falls have all been accounted for, except for Dane Stenson and my grandson, Danny Walker.
My grandma's a zombie! My grandma's a zombie! My grandma's a zombie!
Could you freak a little quieter?
My grandma's a zombie.
Hey, have you seen, Ryan Kankel? Okay, thanks. Ryan!
Yeah?
Where's the statue?
You'll see soon enough. Or not, depending on how much money you got in your pocket.
Look, Ryan, Curtis Danko is alive. When you stole his statue, you woke him up and made him mad. Now he's coming back to take what's his.
Man, you walkers never give up, do you? You think I believe in all this zombie garbage? Do I look like an idiot to you?
Zombie!
Oh yeah, nice try. As if a real zombie would wear a fake rubber mask like this.
Yeah.
Old Walker Falls Cemetery. I'd like to make a reservation
for 1500.
What does he want?
He wants to show us what's under the shroud. He wants to burn our eyes out and make our heads explode.
We're all gonna die. We're all gonna die. I'm not gonna get reelected. We're all gonna die.
Please, don't hurt these people. It's not their fault. If I hadn't wanted to be such a big hero...
Yeah!
No, it's my fault. I'm the one who talked all the other kids into having another Halloween.
Yeah, she did. No! It's my fault. I knew that Ryan broke into your crypt and stole the statue, but I was too afraid to stand up to him or tell anyone.
Yeah, you coward.
Hey, come on. I fell victim to a compelling urban legend. Who knew it was true?
I don't understand.
You stupid, dirty, no good, jealous piece of... Do you mean to tell me that all these years we had no Halloween because of this?
Fault.
swear.
You were there?
Just a prank. You're just trying to scare him. We didn't know the kill would get turned on.
But you said you saw the statue when you went in the kiln the next day. That it was pure evil. You told everyone that it was too horrifying to look at.
How can I let anyone see that I was wrong all along about Curtis Danko?
So you wrote The Curse in the Ashes. You came out pretending that your eyes were burning. You convinced everyone that Curtis was pure evil, and you took away Halloween for 20 years? Why?
Because his statue of your dad was gonna sit in the town square. Not my statue of my dad.
My dad was a great man. He gave until it hurt in ways you will never understand.
Oh, yeah. Your dad was real generous when it came to the arts and crafts and drama and the marching band and all that other sissy stuff. But asking for money for, oh, say, the Football World theme park and RV campground like my dad wanted to build, where real men could take their real sons and eat cheese fries and talk stats and have arm-punching competitions. Ask him about that, and he just stared at you like he was some kind of nutcase.
I call Edward Kanko.
Daddy?
Don't you daddy me. Or you are gonna get a whooping you won't forget for the rest of your years.
Hello, boys. I must look a sight, huh?
Oh, you look good. I mean, you know, all things considered.
You look like you need some rest.
How are you feeling, Uncle Fred?
I'm okay, Danny. Really okay. Now, why don't you help Dana with her mom? I need to spend a minute alone with your dad.
I understand.
So, how are you really feeling, Dad?
That I'm loved.
327 pictures up in the old office that should have told you that a long time ago.
Not by the kids of Walker Falls, James. By you. After tonight, you'll probably never see me again. But I'll see you.
Thanks.
Now, I have one last thing I'd like to do in the time I have left.
What's that?
I'd like to take your mom dancing with the fireflies.
Could you ever see yourself
dancing again?
Hypothetically speaking.
Hypothetically speaking? I think we better keep those two a few blocks apart, at least for the next few years. After all, we have all the time in the world.
Much to worry about when you've got homework and pimples and bullies and girls to deal with in the here and now. But when the sky finally began to brighten, we dancers said goodbye to our loved ones and waltzed into dust, it was comforting to know that the dance wasn't really over.
Schmidt.
Trick or treat. Smell my feet. Give me something good to eat, huh? We are doubling our investment, Herr Walker. On one condition.
What's that?
We put on an even bigger spectacular next year! We have a lot of planning to do. What time shall we meet tomorrow?
7 a.m. bright and early.
Perfect. Sounds good to me.
2 weeks from now. Well, those space food sticks aren't gonna last forever, huh?
But what am I going to do in Walker Falls for 2 weeks, hmm?
Huh? Happy Halloween!
Happy Halloween.